All right, tonight we're going to be doing chicken chow mein. We're going to be using chow mein noodles. These are flour-based noodles. Just set those outside. We're not going to need those for a little while. Right there, it's my extra shelf. Okay, so first thing you want to do is mix up your sauce. This goes together super quick, so you want to get all your ingredients ready to go before you start cooking. So you need 4 cups of water. And then we're going to need 4 teaspoons of chicken bouillon. One, 2, 3, 4. That's also the equivalent of 4 cups of chicken broth, which is just fine also. And mix that in real quick before we add everything else. Okay, so we got 4 cups of broth. Then we're going to need 2 teaspoons of ground ginger. One and two teaspoons of ground ginger. And then you're going to need 2 teaspoons of sesame oil. And if you do it dry ingredients first, then wet ingredients second, then you won't have to keep dirtying up your measuring spoons here. So this sesame oil is so good. It makes you want to use a little more, so we're going to add just a couple more extra dashes. This stuff has got such good flavor. And then we're going to want 2 teaspoons of red wine vinegar. Make sure you give that a shake before you open it like I didn't. There you go. As vinegar has a tendency to settle, all the good stuff stays at the bottom. So, red wine vinegar. I'm sure you could use apple cider vinegar in place of this if you don't have red wine vinegar. Okay, and then you're going to use 6 tablespoons of cornstarch. That's a lot of cornstarch. Okay, 1, 6. Ooh, that's a messy one. Okay, then we're going to be doing 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. 1, 2, 3. A little more or less of anything is perfectly fine, so don't feel the need to continuously measure everything out perfectly. Then we're going to need 2 tablespoons of oyster sauce. And this one's really messy, that's why I like to do it last. And it's really thick, and it's hard to get out by dumping it. It's thick and gooey. There's some left in the spoon, so we're going to do just a little bit extra on this one. Okay. There we go. And let's see if we can scrape that out. We don't want that stuff to go to waste. There we go. Scrape it out just like that. Yeah, making a mess out of the counter already. Oh, I forgot the sugar. Gosh darn, see? You're supposed to have 2 teaspoons of sugar before you dirty everything up. Okay. We'll just guesstimate 1 and 2. And I like a little bit of extra sugar in mine. Just a little bit more. 2 teaspoons of sugar. And this gets to be a big clob in the bottom because of your cornstarch there. So just mix it slowly until you get all that cornstarch off the bottom. And then we're just going to set this aside. Smells good already. Okay, and all that cornstarch is going to settle down to the bottom. soon as we stop stirring it. Now we're going to have to make sure to leave this here because you're going to need to whisk it one more time before you add it into your stuff. Okay, so now we're done with all of this stuff here. We're going to melt 2 tablespoons of butter into a large skillet. No, it won't bite. Whoop. Okay, there we go. Little explosion for you. You're going to get 2 chicken breasts here. And we're going to chop these into small pieces. If you got your chicken just a little bit frozen, like mine still is, it really will cut easier for you. So much easier. But if you start just by slicing it in half down the center right there, then you can turn it because it has a flat edge to sit on. Just set it across onto its flat edge here. And then we can slice it straight down the center. It's pretty frozen. There we go. There we go. Just like that. Okay. And let's turn that butter down just a little bit because it's crackling too much. Okay, now we're just going to dice this up. And we're going to be adding it directly to our skillet right here. Directly to the skillet, right like that. Get all of that out of your way. I got a cutting board on top of my cutting board here so that when I get ready to chop all these vegetables, I don't have to worry about washing my cutting board until I'm ready to get done here. Easy peasy. Okay, and you're just gonna cook this chicken over medium high heat till it's almost cooked through. You don't want it to be all the way done yet. I'll show you. Okay, so right about now though, we're gonna want to add just a pinch of red pepper flakes. You can skip this part if you don't like red pepper flakes. As you cook these, they will become spicier, so only put in half the amount you think it's gonna need. There we go. Put those right over there. Okay, and while this is cooking, I'm going to start chopping our vegetables. And all you need to worry about is which ones take longest to cook. First thing takes longest to cook is carrots. So let's get these carrots chopped up here. And you can peel them if you like to, but I'm not going to take all that time. You can cut them to about that size, about finger length size. And then put the tip of your knife down. And push until it splits, and then just continuously cut those into small little fingers out like that, and then start throwing them in. We might need to turn our chicken down just a little bit because it's cooking fast. It's cooking faster than we can chop vegetables. Put the tip of your knife down first and then try to roll it down. Otherwise, could roll away from you. And carrots are kind of slippery because they're round. There we go. And just cut it at an angle, kind of like that. And then you get these little fingers here. All right, yeah, let's go ahead and turn that down. That's cooking too fast. We don't want our chicken to dry out because it's cooking too fast. When you have a gas stove, it's really hard to turn it down by looking at the number. You actually got to look down at that flame because some of the burners are different from the other burners. And if you want to chop these ahead of time, that's fine too. But carrots like to start turning brown after they've been exposed to air, so don't leave them out too long. There we go. It's going to be about 1.5 cups of carrots. This is going to be about 2 cups of celery and 1.5 cups of carrots. And 1/2 head of cabbage is usually 3 cups. But the cabbage we've been getting lately is super duper small, so I don't know if it is going to be 2 cups, but we're still only going to use a half a head of lettuce or cabbage. Just give that a little stir. We want those carrots to start working their way down to the bottom so they can start cooking. Whoops, leave that right up there. It is going to be really cold here in the next few days. We're going to get down to 18 and 19 degrees on Saturday night and Sunday night already. We still were using the air conditioners until a few days ago. I know, baby. I'm making some food right now. You want a piece of carrot? Yeah. Here you go. Thank you. You're welcome. Just make sure when you're cutting carrots, you put that edge down before you start to cut. You want another piece of carrot, but then I'm not going to have enough carrots for the chicken. One more, okay? Here we go. Happy girl right there. If your kids don't like to eat vegetables, I am so sorry. Just keep putting it on their plate. Even if they say they're not going to eat it, you just keep putting it on their plate. Don't give them any snacks between lunch and dinner. One of these days they'll pick it up and they'll realize how yummy it is. I remember one of my granddaughters thought that she didn't like broccoli. And so the other kids were like, I want more broccoli, I want more broccoli. And she was, why do you guys like broccoli? Broccoli's so gross. And she decided she was going to taste it with some ranch. And she loved it so much, she ate about a half head of broccoli by herself that night. I miss my other granddaughters. I haven't seen them. Oh, it's been about 4 months. Oh, I forgot to use my cutting ring. My finger's starting to get a blister already. You see where I chucked that knife down right there? Yep. Every time. Let me get my ring. I actually just keep it hanging up. I keep my ring for cutting hanging up right where my measuring cups go by the sink. So it's always easily to grab. There we go. That's what you want them to look like right there. My other ones are a little bit long, but that'll be fine. This whole dish goes together just like this. You just start cooking and then you start adding to it. Adding to it. Super easy. Oh, that one there's kind of fat. Give it an extra cut. All right, so our carrots are all in there. Let's get that all stirred around. That chicken is almost cooked all the way through now. We're going to go ahead and turn this heat up just a little bit. Just a little. Let me see. How much did we actually turn it up? Nope, didn't actually turn up very much at all. There we go. Just a little. There we go. Get all those pieces that are still pink down on the bottom. So, nope, there's no more. So the next vegetable we have takes the longest to cook. It's an onion. And it actually cooks really quick, but this one will give you a lot more flavor. We're just putting all of our peels and stuff right over here to the side. So we only have to run back and forth to the garbage once when we're done here. I already trimmed off my celery earlier because I had half a pack of celery still that I'd forgot I had there, and I'd ordered some more and it had to be used up. That's why we're having chow mein that uses a lot of celery. Okay. I'm just gonna cut those into quarter size strips. Okay, good job, babe. Oh, yes, you do. You want to add the onions?
Yeah.
Okay, be careful. It's hot right here. Okay. Good job. Mm-hmm. All right, now let's give it a stir. You want to stir it. Every time you add something in, just give it a stir. Make sure that all your chicken that's uncooked goes into the center, down at the bottom preferably. Okay, do you want to add the celery in when I cut it? Next, we're going to be adding the celery, but this is a very large amount, so we're going to half our piles into two here. I'm just going to squish it all up like this, and then keep the top of your knife down. And slant it backwards just a little bit so that when these fall down, they fall to the back. Watch your fingers. Honey, wait. Wait until Grandma gets done cutting, okay? I'll push it over to you. Like that. Okay? All right. You don't want to get your fingers in the way, huh? Mm-hmm. And as you get down here where you're starting to run out of pieces, go really slow. You get it all together. A couple pieces are tiny. Okay, now we're going to add in the celery. Here you go, babe. All right, be careful. Don't touch the edge. It's very hot. You can eat one. Here it is.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, be careful. Don't drop it. Oh, no.
I don't have to drop it.
Oh, no, girl. Mm-hmm. Okay, nice and slow. Don't let it fall down on the floor.
Okay.
Okay, oh, here's some more. You want me to get a big scoop for you?
Yeah.
Let me help. There you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Be careful. Don't touch the pan. Oh, nice. And more, huh?
Oops.
Careful, careful.
Careful, careful.
Yes, right. Yep, a tiny bit more. You can do it just like that. There you go. Okay, that's the last of the celery. Our chicken is almost completely cooked through. I think it is all the way cooked through at this point, but we're just going to let that cook for a few more minutes, probably. I don't know, probably 4 or 5 minutes so those carrots can get done. Let me see if they're starting to get tender. Mmm. No, not yet.
No, no, they're good. Is it yummy?
Not yet. Okay, and then one of those. These got to cook for a few more minutes before you can add the cabbage. You do not want to add the cabbage too soon because cabbage overcooks within minutes. You're just going to dice it really, really fine. Really, really fine. If it starts to get all skinny like that, and you just turn it and go from the other way.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're just gonna cut it once right down the center like that. And we're gonna set that aside. Do the other half. And cabbage used to last for a month. And lately, I can't get a head of cabbage to last me for a week without going bad. They're super small. I'm pretty sure that they're just taking the outside edges off and putting them back on the shelf as they start to turn. Oops, forgot to cut that one in half. This way here, we just end up with these strips. So they kind of look like everything else. Oop, forgot a celery. Okay. And we could go ahead and turn this heat up at this point. We don't have to wait so long. Turn it up. Turn it up. Now, we're just going to see how tender some of our carrots are here. And that'll tell us how many minutes we got left. You don't want them all the way soft. A couple more minutes. Let me put a lid on this. I got too much in the pan, so the top ones can't cook. I'm going to turn it down just a little bit. Put a lid on. All right, let's check how these are doing. It's been about 2 minutes. We might have to give it two more. Let's take a little taste here. Hot. Oh, perfect. Hot, hot, hot. Okay, now we're just going to add our cabbage in. And don't let this cabbage cook for more than a minute. 1 minute is probably going to be too long. Okay, let's get this out of our way. There we go. I'm going to stir this just until these little clumps are kind of broken in. See how that looks right now? It's going to look a whole bunch different here in a second once that cabbage cooks. We've got a couple of big pieces here. We'll just give it a little chop with the spatula here. Yeah. I know, we're so close to being ready for dinner, girl. It's going to be almost ready. Start cooking all those vegetables. Makes the whole family hungry from all that smell going through the house. Okay. So that's probably enough for that cabbage. See how that looks right there? And some of it's not cooked all the way. Little bits of it still seem a little too firm. That's totally fine. Because what we're going to do now is we're going to add that sauce in and bring it to a boil. And once that gets to a boil, this cabbage will cook just a little bit more. Okay, so you want to give this a stir. Get all that cornstarch off the bottom. Make sure to turn your fire up to high. Just that sauce smells good. Now we're just going to bring that back to a boil. We're going to boil it for about 1 minute. Now be ready to serve. Chinese food is so easy to cook. Only thing hard about it is first initially finding all those weird ingredients they use. But once you stock your kitchen with those, you don't have to buy them very often. Like oyster sauce, sesame oil, ginger. What else did we use? Everybody already has cornstarch and soy sauce in their house. Just a couple of extra ingredients. It's like a $5 investment for those three that we're using today. But you'll be able to make this like 20 times for that $5. Of course, you're not going to make the same dish, but you're going to be able to use it to make other Chinese dishes as well. Look at all those yummy veggies. If you like to serve this over rice or noodles, you can serve it over rice or noodles too. We're just doing something a little different today because I ended up with a couple of extra containers of these chow mein noodles, the chow mein fried noodles. All right, we're starting to boil. It's going to start getting super thick here in a second. It's not really necessary to stir this at this point either, but you can tell my pan's not centered because I'm only boiling on one side. That's all right. You can put a dash of white pepper in this if you like white pepper, but we've used crushed red peppers today, so we don't probably need white pepper. I don't have white pepper anyways. I ran out of that years ago and just decided to not restock it because I don't use it for much more than clam chowder and, yeah, that's about it, just clam chowder. Tastes about the same as black pepper anyway. It's just really finely ground, so you don't see that there's pepper in your food. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're about there. Oh yeah, you see how that's getting really nice and thick? Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, that's good and thick right there. As soon as it starts to lava boil it, yeah, that's when you're going to want to turn this off so it can cool for just a minute before we serve it. And it's going to continue to cook in here for the next minute while we're waiting for it to become serving temperature. So you want to shut this off just a little bit before you think it's done. All right, we'll be back in a minute. All right, and then to serve this up, oh, I don't need this ring on anymore. Let me put that away. Okay, and to serve this up, you're just going to sprinkle some of these chow mein noodles into a bowl. You could use spaghetti noodles for this, or you could use some plain white rice. That'd work just as well. And you're just going to put a couple of big old scoops. Make sure you're using a spoon that'll get all that delicious sauce from the bottom. Spread it over the top of those noodles. Okay, look at that. Yum. Okay, put some extra chicken on there. There you go. Okay, we'll see you guys next time.